Good morning. Welcome to the Sunday School Ministries. I'm Clinton Heidelberg. I have some hot breakfast to share with you on this morning. I'll be right back to share it with you. Each of you, let's pray. Dear Lord, again, you have given us the privilege of prayer. I pray for people who are hurting this morning that they might be healed. Thank you for this lesson this morning. Within this lesson, may we too have the kind of faith that will cause you to smile. Holy Spirit, make usage of me this morning. Teach through me. Teach through me in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, God bless you again to all of our Sunday school partners and champions. We thank God for each of you. I have a big smile on my face this morning because the sun was out this week and we were able to get on the field and we have 12 souls have come to Christ this week. I mean, this is looking like a big month of soul winning. I like winning souls to Jesus Christ. Amen. Herbert and Gene Morgan are champions with us. Morgan Oil Field Pump Repair and Services. If you would like to become a champion with us, it's $20 a month. Our cash app, $CHB271. Our address is on the screen. Phillips Building Supply, 1104 15 North Laurel, have weed eaters and Havana lawnmowers. It is Booth Memorial Funeral Home, 1327 Lee Street, Laurel. Mr. Lee and Mrs. Gloria Booth are there. I've been inside of their facilities. It is some nice. They have annuities, life insurances as well. Booth Memorial Funeral Home, Mays Bush Hog and Lawn Service and Dirt Removal, Mr. Leroy Mays, Wallace Drugs, 520 North Magnolia, where the people are friendly and the prices are right. Thomas Pharmacy, two locations in Laurel, North and South Grocery Depot. Dr. Larry Thomas, see him in the morning. Golden Corral, the best buffet in the USA. Dykett Professional Drugs in front of South Central Hospital. Drive through, a delivery service, all for your convenience. It is DJ Shuttles, downtown Hattiesburg. John Williams, over 25 years of excellent transportation needs. All right, Woolwine in Collins, Mississippi. Mississippi, Mr. Richard Woolwine, pre-owned brand new vehicles, F-150s, 250s, 350s, 450s, Mr. Richard Woolwine. In Seminary, it is John Woolwine, Jeep, Dodges, Rams, brand new, beautiful Woolwine. They treat people like they want to be treated. See John in the morning. All right. Collins Florist and Gift right behind Main Street Cafe in Collins. All right. Ask for Dyra, B&T Cole III. You want to win in insurance? Pause and get with Ben. You will win, win, win. 87 Hal Crocker Road. And Ben has life insurance, home insurance, auto insurance, church insurance. All right. It is Vannetta R. Stone. Vannetta Earl Stone on Leontine Price in the Gold Building. She is a tax consultant. She's a professional, and if you're having problems with your taxes, she can assist you. She has 32 years of experience of working with the IRS. All right, thank you. It is none other than Mo Print Shop, Mount Olive, Mississippi. I like saying that. Mount Olive, Mississippi, Mo Print Shop. Miss Marcia Hall is there. They have drop-off boxes for UPS and deliveries right there in Mount Olive, Mississippi. Business cards for your personal business, and they can make your events cards, flyers, and all occasions, obituaries for your loved ones. They got it going on. Mount Olive, Mississippi. The name, Mo Print Shop. All right. Thank you so kindly. It is none other than our next sponsor is Superior Commercial Services, cleaning services, CL Keys, for your office, for your business, for your apartments, for your projects, residential or commercial. They can get it clean for you. CL Keys, Superior Commercial Cleaning Services. Try them in the morning. All right. Moore Chiropractic Clinic. Dr. Debbie Moore. Your back is hurting, your neck is hurting, your joints are hurting. When people go there, they go there hurting. When they leave, they say, wow, relief. Moore Chiropractic Clinic. Purvis, Mississippi. Hattiesburg. Coming to Slidell, Mississippi, as Carrier, Mississippi. All right, thank you so kindly. Now, the breakfast is hot this morning. I got some breakfast to share with you. I want to thank Keith Barlow. I want to thank Sheriff Charlotte Sim, Forest County. Pfizer. We will be in Newton, Mississippi today with Bishop Andrew George in his anniversary. Pastoral anniversary with his wife there, and my people will be with me, and they will be with me the first Sunday in May when we go down to Mobile, Alabama with Pastor Cleveland McFarling and his anniversary. We have 11 pastoral anniversaries to do before October. Assisting pastors. The subject of our lesson this morning is Faith of a Centurion. Our key verse, Luke 7:7. Let me read it in your hearing. Wherefore, neither though I myself worthy to come unto you, but say in a word, and my servant shall be healed. At this time, our introductory study, our introduction and biblical background. The time of this writing is around A.D. 70. The geographical location, Galilee, where Jesus did most of his preaching and teaching. You biblical scholars know that he did more teaching than he did preaching, Jesus, because he knew that teaching is reaching, teaching is developing, teaching is educational, teaching is empowering. God Almighty, near the northwestern Sea of Galilee, in a place called Capernaum, which was his home base, his headquarters. The focus point of this lesson is faith resort is not last resort. Faith is the only resort. Our purpose of this lesson teaches when faith is in action, distance doesn't matter. Distance doesn't matter when one has faith. Our main objective, remote healing within reach. If you got the faith, just remember he's within reach. No matter how low, how wide, how long, God is within reach. No matter what you have done, he's within reach. God Almighty. Jesus in his Galilean ministry here, his ministry, his call was to the ones who were hurting, the outcasts, the disenfranchised, the blackballed and redlined ones, the ones that were overlooked. He reached out to them with kindness. It is said that faith is the substance of things hoped for, evidence of things not seen. Hebrews 11 and 1. Substance is a legal term in real estate where one says, this is my house. It only becomes your house when the mortgage is paid off. You made a deposit for 15 years, 20 or 30 years, but it's really not your house until you have the deeds. And the mortgage holder has the deeds. And when it's paid off, you can say, this is my house. Then when you get the deeds, you got the substance. God Almighty. This brings us now to the exposition and application of the scriptures. Desperate need. Luke 7, 1 through 5. Situation in Capernaum. Now, when he had ended all his sayings in the audience of the people, he entered into Capernaum. And a certain centurion servant was there. A centurion servant was there. You see, in a centurion in the ancient Eastern culture was a Roman soldier over 100 men, symbolized a captain or a lieutenant. The root word in the ancient Greek anthropology is kaenome, which mean at a glance over 100 men he was over. The word teaches here that it is equivalent to a lieutenant in the army. And he was there, and this man had a sick servant, an enslaved servant, was sick and at the point of death, the lesson teaches. But I want to tell you, when it seems like you're at the point of death in your life, physically, economically, socially, collectively, when it seems like you're at the point of death, it's all over for you. You want to end things. I want to tell you, he specializes when you're at the point of death, when you're almost at the end. He's specializing in turning things around. I know he can. I know he can. I've tried him by faith. He has always, God has always come through for Clinton Heidelberg. What about you? What about you? And when he heard of Jesus, Romans 10, 17 says, faith cometh by hearing, hearing by the word of God. This centurion heard about Jesus. He was beseeching him that he would come and heal his servant. This word beseech means to beg or to make a plea. Please come. My servant that I love is almost dead. And the message went out and they came to Jesus and besought him instantly, saying that this man is a fine man, because, but he's a Gentile, but he built us a synagogue where we can study God's word. He spent his own money. There was some debate among biblical expenditures whether or not this man was saved or lost. We do know he was a giver. He spent his monies to build a synagogue for the Jews. He looked beyond culture and racial lines, wrote a check to build God a place for people to study his word. I want to tell you, when one's heart becomes open, your purse comes open. When your heart becomes open, your pocketbook comes open. Your wallet comes open. Your checkbook comes open. Your Visa card comes open. When your heart is open to God. God. The lesson goes on to say here, and Jesus went with them. And when he was afar off, the man sent others to say, tell him, he doesn't really have to come to my house. I'm unworthy for him to come to my house. I'm not fit for him to come to my house. I have missed the mark too many times. I'm short. I don't want him to come to my house. I'm unworthy. But if he would just speak a word, say a word. This is our key verse. I hope, Harry, to get back there shortly. Well, over 700 times, the word Lord, the title Lord, is used in the Bible here. And they said here unto Jesus, Lord, in verse number 6-7, Lord, trouble not thyself, for I am not worthy. Lord here is used many times. It could have meant that Jesus now was this man's Lord, or it could have meant that sir, we honor you. In the ancient Eastern culture, we call you sir, Lord. Twofold there. And he says, now I'm over others and others are under me, but still I'm not worthy to come for you to come to me, to my house. And Jesus says in the latter part of verse 9, I have not found in all of Israel, out of your synagogues, your temples, out of all of your worship, I have not found anyone that has such a great faith as this man. And when they left there, they went back home in verse 10, and it says, the servant that was at point of death had now been made whole. God Almighty. Well, this brings us now to our gemstones for today. I would like for you to get your journals and your notepads and share these gemstones with your students on this morning. Before I get there, our seven dynamic takeaways. I want to thank each of you for getting these takeaways. And this is our 8th edition, and people in Mississippi and in other states are getting them for their Sunday school classes. They are spiritually oriented. They are rich in teaching and understanding. And I want to thank each of you for purchasing one. God bless you. Real good. Now, to make this particular lesson here, Coach May, applicable, to make this lesson resonate, to make this lesson relevant to life today, let's glean from the basis of our textual discussion these gemstones on this morning. Number one, faith causes one to possess spiritual disciplines. No wavering. Faith leads to saying, I don't reckon, I know. After much growth and much maturity in Christ, faith leads you to saying, I know for myself. I know that I know, I know, I know, I know. God Almighty. Also, faith leads to contrition. This centurion says, I'm not worthy. I don't have the wherewithal within me spiritually for you to come to my house. Sometimes when there's a need in your life, in your family, if there's a need, sometimes you got to be willing to be contrite and say, Lord, I need your help. I know I'm not what I ought to be, should be, or could be, but I know you a way maker. I know you a helper. I need you right now. And contrition will take place. 51 Psalm says, David says, I know I've done wrong, but I need you to create in me a clean heart, O God. Renew a right spirit in me. Contrition, God Almighty. Secondly, get this gemstone here. When there's real faith in action, faith shows empathy for others. You gotta practice empathy. When someone else is going through, it might not be your color. It may not be your culture. May not be your race. May not be folk that look like you, but believers who have faith in Jesus Christ, they show empathy. They feel for others. Their love for others is heartfelt, God Almighty. And they say within themselves, that could be me. And the love of God that's in me is going to reach out to him, reach out to her. This Gentile reached out to the Jews. What we must do in our third gemstone is this. The white man must appreciate and celebrate the black man's culture. The black man must appreciate and celebrate the white man's culture. We all need each other. May have different backgrounds, different cultures, but in Christ, we need each other. God Almighty. Next is this. This man received a twofold blessing. How so, Pastor Heidelberg? Well, physically, he was healed. He didn't die. He got his healing. Secondly, spiritually, he was healed. How you say that? Because the word says he was made whole. There's one thing to be healed. There's another thing to be made whole. When you're made whole, that means physically and spiritually. And can't nobody make you whole but Jesus Christ, God Almighty. Number six, Jesus Christ, get this teaching. He accepts unworthy folk. God Almighty. This man says, I'm not worthy for you to come under my roof. It doesn't matter how low you have become in your practices of wrong. It does not matter if you feel disenfranchised. It doesn't matter if you have missed the mark 1,000 times. He, with his new graces and new mercies, he accepts those who are unworthy, meaning he has already accepted us into the beloved. God Almighty. Get this teaching now. Next is this one. The conception that says you must have a blind leap of faith. No. You don't have to have a blind leap of faith. All you have to have is faith. God Almighty. In the Old Testament, Before they were called Christians, they were called believers. That come from the anthropology of the Greek pistos, believers, people who believe in Jesus Christ. We are believers, and when you are a believer, when they pray with expectancy. And this man said, just speak a word, just say so. Your word can defy the laws of nature and the atmosphere and the velocity of the wind. Your word can zip and zap and be there and heal my servant. Just speak a word. And I want to tell somebody that's listening now in your situation, maybe by faith, ask him just to speak a word. God Almighty. Luke 7:7, our key verse. He says, I'm undeserving. I'm lacking. I'm void and I'm empty. But if I know if you speak a word, healing and wholeness can ensue. I'm Clinton Heidelberg. May God bless you. Take care of yourselves. Take care of others. Real good.
If it had not been for